Hey everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this online course tutorial, we're going to be going through exactly how to set up your first online course using 100% free software. So there's definitely gonna be some jerry-rigging and duct taping in this one, but if you're on a super tight budget and just don't have the cash to purchase your own WordPress site or use one of the other solutions out there, this is for you, 100% free software. Make sure you check out the links in the description to other helpful videos in terms of putting together the content for your online courses, as well as some other alternatives if you have just $50 or $100 to spend. With that, let's go ahead and jump into my screen. I'll walk you through the duct tape sales funnel that I put together to collect leads, and then I'll walk you through the actual sales process for the online course and, of course, delivering the course content. And to do this, we're going to be using a couple of pieces of software. We're going to use Google Sites, we're going to use MailChimp, we're going to use Zapier, and we will use Wave Accounting. You can also use PayPal instead of Wave, but I'll get to that in a second. So the very first page we have in our process is our landing page or squeeze page. And this was put together using Google Sites. It's free, and all we did was put an image on the page, a couple of bullet points, and then embedded a form from MailChimp. Link in the description to a full video that walks you through how to set up all of these pages. So here's a squeeze page version, and the only difference between really the landing page and the squeeze page is that with the squeeze page, you're not having the bullet points, you just have a nice graphic and say, enter your name and email, and here's another example. So this is what happens before someone even gets on your email list to learn about your course. And as you can see, Google Sites is very easy to use. It's a kind of drag and drop interface. It's very easy to type text. It is super basic. Pretty much you have text, images, and you can do some embed codes, and that's about all you can do with Google Sites, but that's all we need in order to start growing our email list before we sell our online course. And before we move forward, something that's very important with Google Sites is you can come over here to Pages and make sure that you go drop down and say, don't show in navigation. That way you can make one website for all of your landing pages and squeeze pages, and the navigation doesn't show up in the top right here. The other cool thing is we can either make a downloads page or a video sales page. So this is going to just depend upon how you want to sell your online course. If you have a lead magnet that is separate from your sales message, then you'd go ahead and use this downloads page where you can give them access to whatever PDF or diagram they opted in for. You could just use Google Drive and insert a Google Drive link here, and they can click and download and go through whatever you've offered them. In this particular example though, let's say they've gone to this squeeze page, they enter their name and email, and then they go directly to our sales page for our course, our, you know, duct tape sales funnel system. So they watch this video, I recommend using the free plan of Vimeo, and if you run out of space when you're starting to put together your online course, you can go ahead and switch to using YouTube unlisted videos. Just make sure that none of them are monetized, right? Because you don't want ads showing up on your course videos. So let's say someone goes through this, they watch it and they go, yeah, you know what? I think I'll want to purchase your membership website. They can go ahead and click purchase now. That's just a big image. And I hyperlinked it to go to the Wave Apps checkout cart. Now you see here, they can get the duct tape funnel course. All they have to do is enter their name and email along with their billing information and they're good to go. So I want to walk through how to quickly set this up using Wave Accounting. So Wave Accounting is a free accounting software that allows you to do invoicing and payments and payroll and all that fun stuff. But what's really cool is they recently introduced checkouts. So you can go ahead and just go to waveapps.com or just Google search Wave Accounting. You'll be taken to this page. You can sign up 100% free. And then inside of your dashboard, you can go to sales and checkouts. And then you can actually create as many products as you want. So I'm going to just go ahead and name this Duct Tape Sales Funnel Course. It gives you the option to have a little success message. And in this success message, you can actually put a link directly to the course that you're going to set up, the course site we're going to set up later in this tutorial. Or you can just say, hey, check your email for your course login details. And when we click save and share, you'll be able to copy this link right here. And you'll have a page that pretty much looks just like this, where people can enter their billing information and purchase your course. So this is typically the biggest hurdle that I find with trying to create a course for free is how do you use a payment processor that you don't have to pay for? The other thing you can do here with that I'm not going to go into is you can actually use PayPal. So inside of your PayPal account, you can actually set up some products. You can set up a pay me link and just have this go straight over to PayPal instead of going to Wave Apps checkout. Now, you've gotten paid. There is something else that we need to do though in order to connect Wave to your MailChimp account, because right now they've paid, but we need to give them access to the course and specifically access to the membership website that we're going to be building inside of Google Sites, which is this right here. So I'll show you how to build this in a second. If you're still watching and getting some value, go ahead and hit that like button. Comment below if you have any questions, because we're about to get a little technical. And this is where inside of Wave Accounting, we need to go over to integrations and use something called Zapier. Now, what Zapier is going to do, we can scroll down here, is it's going to allow you to connect Wave to MailChimp, which means when someone enters their name and email in that checkout form, Zapier, which is free for up to 5 zaps, so you can go to zapier.com, you can search, you can see here's the integration right here. It's free to use so that whenever someone fills out the checkout form, they're automatically added to your customer list inside of MailChimp. And inside of that email is where you're going to send them the private link to your membership website. So all that's left for us to do is actually put together our membership website. And the easiest way to do this is using Google Sites. So here's an example of a membership site that I put together for free using Google Sites. I just embedded an unlisted YouTube video. All of these links are direct to a Google Drive folder that I've set. And what's really nice about using Google Drive is it's pretty much free for up to 15 gigabytes of stuff, right? And you can set all of the links so that they only work if someone has been given the actual link URL. So what this means is everyone who gets access to your membership website can easily download all of your content, and you don't have to worry about people who aren't on these pages finding your content. Now, I realize that there is a big kind of loophole here in terms of content, right? Because all of these links are private, but they're not locked because you don't actually have a login page. These are just all private pages that your users can only get to if they have the actual link. So it only really protects your content from people who aren't supposed to be seeing it, accessing it. However, it doesn't protect all your content from your members potentially sharing it with people who haven't paid. So that's kind of the big downside of going this free route. But the good news is after a couple of sales, you'll have plenty of income to switch over to WordPress, and there are plenty of free WordPress plugins that allow you to lock down all of your content, and then you can get as fancy as you'd like. So let's just go ahead and go through everything we've done in this tutorial. Comment below if you have any questions. So the very first thing we did using Google Sites is we just created a basic landing page, link in the description to a video that dives into how to use Google Sites and build all these pages from scratch, where we just have a nice image showing our lead magnet, and then we have a couple of bullet points, and we embedded a form from MailChimp. Once they enter their name and email, they can either be taken to a downloads page, and then we'll follow up with them via email, or in this particular example, we sent them straight to a sales page where they watch a YouTube video and then say, okay, great, I want more of your membership stuff. They click purchase now, and we take them over to the Wave shopping cart, or you can use PayPal if you'd like. There's plenty of documentation inside of PayPal showing you how to accept payments via PayPal. And then to make sure that we actually collect their name and email inside of our MailChimp account, we used a free Zapier from Zapier, where essentially we connected Wave to MailChimp so that every time someone fills out that checkout form, they're automatically added to our email list. And then inside of MailChimp, something I didn't include in this tutorial, is where you'll send them an email that has a private link to your membership website. And of course, your membership website is built using Google Sites, And as you can see, it's very, very simple and easy to use. I mean, you can easily drag elements around. You can easily add more text and more videos. You can change up the fonts. There's plenty you can do inside of this free version of Google Sites to make an awesome membership site. So if you got some value out of this video, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe for more fun and innovative ways to save on the cost of your marketing stack. I really did have a blast trying to figure out how to put together a membership site and really a full sales funnel without spending a dime on any software at all. Of course, this is a duct tape funnel, right? I highly recommend that once you get some cash flow in, you upgrade to WordPress and then start building out complexity from there. So again, hit that like button and subscribe if you got some value. Comment below if you have any questions on building your free sales funnel and putting together your free course. And until the next video, keep building the business you love.